Congratulations, you are now qualified for the Tokyo Olympic Games. What is going through your mind right now?
Wow, a really special and hard day. It start with at 9 in the morning with the first fight, and now I'm done. So I really, really happy because I worked so hard. So I'm really happy.
Do you already realize, you know, all the hard work, all these years, and now finally you're going to the Olympic Games and your performance in the final, we'll talk about it later, but flawless performance, congratulations. Can you walk us through your competition from your perspective today, you know, first fight, second fight, how did you feel, the biggest challenge? Walk us through your day of competition.
The real hard things, it's me against me all the time. I need to do my best, and you know, all the time I in pressure, and I really happy now. I can talk so good, but I really happy.
Perfect. Was there any more challenging moment than the other today? Any fight that you can think about, any opponent?
Every fight was really hard mentally because all the time you need to do your best, and every time you scared to lose but want really to win. It's really hard, but I'm happy now. And that's it.
Perfect. What a strange year, you know. It's been a year now that this competition was supposed to happen. With the lockdown, you had to wait and wait. Can you talk to us a little bit about this moment for you as an athlete when you have to stay motivated, stay engaged, stay ready physically? How did you manage to stay and be able to perform like you did today?
The hardest part was to don't know where, when it's going to be. Okay, all the time it's in May and then in October, and all the time you don't know when it's going to be, and all the time you need to be focused on training and focused on do your best, and it's really hard to be focused all the time and don't know when it's going to be.
For sure. And when you had no really clear guidelines, what did you focus on? Like, as you said, focus on you. How were you and your team able to manage to stay, you know, in physical shape? Because there is a difference between being fit, you know, in the gym and staying in competition shape. And you proved today that you managed to do that. What was the key, you think, for that?
I think the key is my coach, because all the time he pushed me to do my best in training and in fight, in competition, before the competition. All the time my coach said to me to be focused and ready. And, you know, so my coach is the key for me.
Can you talk to us a little bit also about performing inside of a bubble environment? You know, it's different. There is not the crowd. There is no, you know, the teammates. How does it feel?
For be honest, that my team, it's really motivate me all the time. So it's really hard to don't listen to them, cheer for me. But I know my family and my team is all the time want that I win. So I do my best all the time for them also.
For sure, for sure. And so now you have 80 something days to be ready for Tokyo. How do you gonna, you know, it's the last race. How do you focus on making sure you can optimize this time? What do you think is gonna be key? And what are you gonna focus on to be ready on that day?
And for sure, I going to watch my fight and see what I did not really good and what I did very good. So to focus on the bad things and also to improve the good thing. So this is, I think, and my coach, I sure that he find a way to push me.
For sure. Do you have one last comment maybe to describe this feeling and maybe to also say thank you or to share some comments to anybody that you would like to?
I'm really happy, really, really, really happy. I want to thank my father and mother all the time, help me, and my boyfriend is also compete tomorrow, and for sure my coach is the best, and thank you for everybody. I'm really happy.
Thank you so much. And congratulations, and keep going. We'll be watching you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.